Right. I've just been making a point to get up extra shots, and I think I just had that confidence. And we had a good practice yesterday, so I guess that carried over.
Alexa, are you comfortable as a freshman in a big game environment
like this? For sure. I mean, I have great upperclassmen like Rel and Drea, and they talk to me every day in practice and just give me that confidence. And I love games like that, close games where you have to grind it out.
What about defensively?
Yeah. I mean, I've said before, this is the most I've ever worked on defense playing basketball, and I feel so much more comfortable and confident in my defensive ability since I've got here.
Burial, Oregon State, 6-9 in the arc in the first half, 0-7 in the second half. What adjustments did you guys make?
I think we just put an emphasis on it. I think sometimes we were helping in on the penetration, and coaches kind of told us at halftime that we want to force them to make layups, but we couldn't let them get any more threes off. And as a team, we kind of had a team goal where we were going to give them no more than 6 threes in this game, because we know that's what they like to do. And so in halftime, you know, we saw the stat sheet and was like, all right, y'all, you can't give up anymore. So I just think everyone took heed to that. We made sure that we guarded the three-point line.
How key is Izzy when she can erase those penetrators that do make it through?
Oh, it's unbelievable. As a perimeter player, it gives you the confidence to know that you can get up into somebody and defend. Because if you do happen to get beat, you got somebody back there who's going to take care of it for you.
Aria, can you talk about the points you get from Alexa in this game? I mean, how important they were,
Well, they were very crucial. She came in with a lot of confidence. Like she said, she's been working on her jump shot, and that's something that's going to come. She's a freshman. The tempo of the game is a lot faster than high school and whatnot, so I think she's getting adjusted to it. Today, she's able to come in and make plays on the offensive and defensive end for us.
Did you feel better in this game with all of the tempo and such like that? I mean, they've got some really good guards. How did you feel about it?
Yeah, I mean, I just came in knowing that defense was the most important, and I wanted to make sure I worked hard on that end first and the offense would come. Coach Elzy and Coach Law always say that, just play hard defense, offense going to come, and I think that's what happened.
Did they take a while to adjust to them? I mean, they look like they run some nice stuff, and they've got a lot of people can make shots.
Yeah, they're a very good offensive team. They have great spacing, and like Rel said, I think we made some adjustments at halftime and just made an emphasis on guarding the three-point line, and we came out and did that the second half.
Ariel, when did you add mopping to your point guard responsibilities?
You know, whatever it takes for us to get the win. They said the floor was a little wet, and that was on our offensive end. So I had to make sure if Izzy caught the ball on the block, she didn't slip or anything. So whatever it takes, all areas, you know. Well, the ref asked if it was wet, and Izzy was like, oh, it's fine. And I was like, do you need me to get the mop? And she was like, yeah, go ahead, because we didn't see anybody over there. So I was like, all right, well, I'll grab the mop, clean this up real quick, make sure I get it good so we had no issues, and then had to get the crowd involved also.
Were you guys mindful trying to get to the free throw line as many times as you did today? Were you, I noticed a few times you were driving looking like, well, I'm either going to get the shot or I'm going to try to get to the free throw line. Is that a conscious thought with you guys at all?
Honestly, I don't think so. I just think on the offensive end, we played very aggressive. We were the aggressor on the offensive end, and we attacked. We knew we had to make them defend and make them move on the offensive end, and so I think that played in our favor today.
You guys have now beaten two top 10 teams in a row. What does this just say about your team right now?
I would still say we're a work in progress. Coaches always tell us there's always room for improvement. We can always get better. As we know, we have a tough SEC schedule coming up ahead of us, and so every day we have to continue to improve.
Talk about, you had 26 points off turnovers. How did you feel like you were able to affect them with your press?
I think the press was very good. I think that was a good call by Coach Warlick. But I think we just got after it. We made them work hard, and I think once they got the ball into the front court, you know, they were kind of tired. And it was like, oh, we got to score now. And I think it definitely played in our favor. And I got to give a bunch of credit to Andrea Carter. She was tremendous tonight. I know 24, she had like 14 or 16 points in the first half. And in the second half, she held her 1-8 shooting. So I think in the second half, we definitely just knew that we had to get stops on the defensive end and that we could not keep trading baskets with them. We claim her as our defensive stopper, and she took heed to that, and she knew that that's what we needed for us to get this W today.
Coach,
Ariel, do you think you guys can turn the corner defensively?
I think so. Like I said, there's always room for improvement, but I think this team is headed in the right direction.
Alexa, at one point, you guys were basically trading baskets with them. You guys came into that 4-6 point lead. How did you guys get some separation finally there at the end?
I think it just came down to getting stops on the defensive end. We knew we had to buckle down and make sure they got no threes, and, you know, we just buckled down and got stops. And
when Izzy is making blocks like that, you can hear the crowd. The crowd's definitely. How does that fire up the team when she does that?
Oh, it gives you so much energy. I don't know, words can't explain it. Just to know to get that and come back on defense and get another stop and then give up an easy bucket and just, I don't know, it's just amazing. Like, I wish I could do it. No, solid. I didn't know that. I think our post did a great job, like they always do, just keep them out. Also, on the perimeter, I think the guards had good ball pressure, which made it hard for them to see those inside passes that they're probably used to making.
Izzy, can you talk about the blocks?
I just saw those guards, you know, looking towards the rim and ready to drive, and I wanted to help our guards out if they weren't able to get over the top. So I just wanted to be that presence in the paint for us tonight.
You were moving about as well as I've seen you move in a while. How much more comfortable are you with your knee and your brace? And you just seem like you weren't even thinking about it in this game.
You know, I have to embrace that. I have to know that I'm going to play with it, you know. For as long as I can, I can't worry about it, and it's going to be a part of me for as long as I need it. And I just got to stop worrying about it and play my game.
Did it feel good to be out there for 35 minutes tonight? That's your season high.
It was a lot. I haven't done that many minutes since last year. And, you know, I got my cardio up for sure today, but and it helped. But, you know, I'm just going to have to get used to those minutes as well.
Your point guards have to get you the ball, but apparently they also have to mop up the floor for you now.
She was so cute out there, wasn't she? Look at her mom.
Made Ariel.
I was happy for her. Thank you, Ariel.
Oh, you're welcome. I didn't want you to hurt yourself.
Thanks.
Izzy, can you talk about the points you guys got from Alexa today?
They were huge. You know, I try to locate our shooters, and definitely Lex is a great shooter, and I try to locate her, and I just wanted to get her open, so I just continued to set people screens, and she did a great job reading them. And I'm glad she stepped up for us today.
Izzy, Oregon State mentioned that this is pretty much a bloodbath inside. Did you feel every bit of that too?
Yeah, for sure. But I'm used to it, and I got to embrace it. Dean tells us every day we're the blue-collar workers, and that's just a part of our game, and you can't get frustrated. And at times I do, but I just got to remember it. I'm a post, and it happens.
Thank you very much.